Hi everyone, my name is Will Valida. I'm a software engineer and cloud architect. And in this video, we're going to talk about using workload identities for bicep deployments in GitHub Actions. This is the second video of my container app series. And in my previous video, we talked about how we can create container app resources using bicep and then deploy those resources using the Azure CLI. This is fine for starters, but in this video, what we're going to do is we're going to take it to the next level and deploy our resources using GitHub Actions instead. Now, to deploy our resources, we're going to need to authenticate to our Azure subscription in our GitHub Actions workflow. In order to do this, we'll need to use something called Workload Identities. So Workload Identities are a feature of Microsoft Entra ID, which is a global identity service from Microsoft. A workload is an automated process or system that usually doesn't have to have a human directly running it. A workload can essentially sign into Microsoft Entra ID, but there's no human to sign in and interact with the authentication process. So workload identities don't have multi-factor authentication or similar protections because those features require a person to do something to prove their identity. Microsoft Entra has a concept of an application, which represents a system, piece of software, a process, or other some non-human agent. You can think in this scenario of a deployment workflow as an application too. When you create an application and tell Microsoft Entra about it, you create an object called an application registration. An application registration represents the application in Microsoft Entra ID. An application registration can have federated credentials associated with it. Federated credentials don't require you to store any secrets. Instead, what they do is they enable a Microsoft Entra application to be used with a supported service like GitHub. When your GitHub Actions workflow needs to authenticate, it contacts Microsoft Entra ID through GitHub. GitHub will tell Microsoft Entra ID the name of the GitHub organization and the repository, along with some other information as well. If you've configured a federated credential that matches the repository's details, Microsoft Entra will authenticate your deployment workflow, and then the workflow can use permissions that you've assigned to your application. So let's see how this works. In this demo, we'll create a workload identity for our GitHub Actions workflow file, then we'll grant that identity with the permissions it needs to make changes to our Azure environment, and then we'll use the workload identity that we've created in our GitHub Actions workflow file. Let's dive in. Okay, so let's set up a workload identity that we're going to use to deploy our resources to our Azure environment. So first things first, we're going to need to create two variables, one for our GitHub organization name, and that's going to be my username on GitHub, and then I'm going to create one for my repository name, and that's going to be let's build ACA. That's the name of the repository that we're storing all our code in for these tutorials. Cool. So now we need to create an application registration for our workload ID. And I'm going to do this by storing this in a variable, application registration. I'm going to use new AZ AD application. Give it the display name of health tracker dot dash production. Cool, now that's gonna go ahead and create my application registration. And then through this variable, we can now access important pieces of information from our application registration, such as the application ID, which is the unique identifier for our app registration. And we're gonna use this when the workflow needs to sign into Azure. And also the object ID, and that's the unique identifier that Azure AD assigns. Now that our application registration has been created, we need to assign it with federated credentials. This is an application credential that doesn't require us to manage any secrets like passwords or keys, which can expire after a certain amount of time. These federated credentials will allow Microsoft Entra ID and GitHub to trust each other, which is why we call it federation. So when our GitHub workflow attempts to sign in, GitHub will provide information about the workflow, so Microsoft Entra ID can determine whether or not this workflow has sufficient permissions to sign in. And this information can include the GitHub user, the name of the repository, the branch of our repository that the workflow is running on, and the environment that the workflow is targeting. So in my GitHub Action workflow file, which I'll show a bit later, we'll be deploying off my off the lessons branch to my production environment. So what I'm going to need is I'm going to need to create two federated credentials for my workload identity that associates my production environment with my GitHub repository. So let's start with the environment. So in my GitHub Action workflow file, I'll be deploying off my main branch into my production environment. So I'll need to create two federated credentials for my workload identity that associates my production environment with my GitHub repository. So the first thing I'm going to do is create a federated credential for my production environment. I'm going to copy and paste this and press enter. So there's my federated credential for my production environment. And now I'm going to do one for my main branch as well. So a little bit of copy and paste magic. And there we go. So notice here for our application object ID, we've used the object ID for our workload identity that we created earlier. And for our subject, we've organized, we assign our policies that associate our production environment and GitHub repository to our workload identity. So this covers the authentication part of our workflow. So now we need to authorize our workload identity to contribute resources to our resource group. And for this, we can use Azure RBAC to assign a role to our workload identity. For this, we're going to need to create a service principal. So for this, I can use the application ID of our resource group that our workflow is going to deploy resources to. So I've already created my resource group, so I'm going to retrieve it and store it in a variable like so. So I'm going to call this production resource group. Actually, what I'm going to do, I'll get some real estate going. So create the variable production resource. Ugh, caps lock today. What's going on there? There we go. Group. You can do that get AZ resource group. And name will be RG Health Tracker. That's the name of my resource group. Cool. And then I can use the ID property to create a service principal for it. So just going to copy and paste that. There it is. Now that our service principal has been created, we can assign a role to it. So for the purposes of this demonstration, I'm going to give my service principal the owner role over my resource group. Because in future lessons, I'm going to be covering role assignments, so I'll need that level of permission over my resource group. There are many considerations of what role and scope you should give your service principal. So depending on your scenario and your use case, do spend some time thinking about this. So to create our role assignment, we can use the app ID of our workload identity and the owner role for our role definition name. And for our scope, we can use the resource ID for our resource group. So I'm going to go ahead and just paste that line of code in. So that is going to go ahead and create my role assignment, which looks like it's been successful. Now, with everything set up, we can now set up our secrets in GitHub Actions. So we're going to need three things. We're going to need the client ID, the tenant ID, and subscription ID to authenticate to Azure. So let me just clear that up, and I will copy and paste this in. I'm going to print these out to the console. I'm also going to blur it in the video as well, so that you can't see the actual values because they are secrets. So there we go. There are my values for my client ID, tenant ID, and subscription ID. And one by one, what I'm going to do is I'm going to copy these values and save them as secrets in our GitHub repository. Cool. So now that we have got those values from our workload identity, we can now copy the values that we generated from before and save them as secrets in GitHub in our GitHub repository. So here I've got my client ID, subscription ID, and tenant ID as secrets that I can use in my actions workflow file. So now if I switch into Visual Studio Code, I can use our workload identity in my GitHub Actions workflow file. So the first thing that you need to kind of add in your deployment workflow file is the ability for your deployment workflow to request tokens. And we can do this using the permissions property here. So I've got the write on ID token and contents set to read. Now in various steps, we can actually use our secrets that we've saved earlier in our GitHub repository to sign into Azure. And when we use workload identities, we need to specify these three inputs like so. So I've got in this step, within this validate job in my workflow file, I've got, when I sign into Azure, I've got my client ID referencing that secret, along with the tenant ID and Azure subscription. And we use this to sign into Azure to when we deploy our Bicep templates to Azure. So here's a good example. Here in this validate stage, I've got this step to sign into Azure using those secrets, as I mentioned before. And then we're gonna run some pre-flight validation on our Bicep template. And here I've got a main.bicep file and also a parameters file that I'm passing through as well. So if I go back into GitHub, into the repository, into Actions, and here's something that I deployed earlier. It took about 5 minutes to run, so I'm not going to show you that in the video. I did deploy this ahead of time. If I go into any one of these stages, so if I go into that validate stage, I can see when I open up this sign into Azure step, I can see that it's going to be using my workload identity to authenticate to Azure. And if I look at my resource group in Azure, I can see my resources have been successfully deployed to that resource group before. Cool. So in this video, we talked about workload identities, what they are, and how we can use them in GitHub Actions deployment workflows. We learned how we can use federated credentials to authenticate our workflows without having to store any secrets. And then we learn how to use our workload identities in our GitHub Actions. I hope you all enjoyed this clip. If you did, give it a like. And if you want to see more videos like this, don't forget to subscribe. Wherever you are in the world, I hope you're having a great day, and we'll see you all next time.